This is Hawthorne Place, public housing on the city's east side. Yesterday, we were out here talking about infestation cockroaches. Today, we're back for rats.
This is the rat that Velray Morgan and her dog fought to the death recently.
Come to find out, the second time I came down, she done pulled it out of the up under microwave, and it's a rat, and it's attached to the trap, to the sticky trap, but it didn't pull his body off of the sticky trap. And now it's trying to fight me, so now I got to move my broom and a mop trying to get it.
So you're a rat fighter.
I guess so. I don't want to be. Yeah. I'm scared of them.
While rodents and their residue pollute Velray's apartment, across the way at Regine Pippin's apartment, it's cockroaches that keep her up at night.
My first night here, I started seeing all the rodents in the kitchen, which is the roaches and stuff. 1,000 roaches. I don't come downstairs in my kitchen without shoes on, period. Because I'm stepping on them, killing them. It's a whole bunch. Babies, big ones. It's a whole bunch.
The roaches in another neighbor's apartment were still wiggling when we found them on Monday. While debris and trash are being picked up and speed bumps painted, and apartments rehabbed in advance of a federal property audit,
they go on running.
Neighbors at IHA have a plea for Executive Director John Hall.
To make it better for us over here, we shouldn't have to live like this.
The changing of the chemicals, making stronger solutions so that we're not just treating the problem, but we have a goal of eradicating. My vision is for that all of our residents live in a pest-free environment. That is something that I've been given that message and that vision to with the tenants as I've met with them over the last several months.
And some of the neighbors tell me the only way to defeat the rodent, the mice, and rat population is just feed the stray cats. They'll keep that population down. At Hawthorne Place on the city's east side, Russ McQuaid, Fox 59 News.